afternoon from beautiful Brisbane, Australia, where it's definitely winter. Welcome to Complex PTSD TV. My name's Linda. I am a certified trauma recovery coach, and I have also experienced complex PTSD in my life, where it took away, stripped me of everything in my life. You can read more information on the website. And I do take bookings. Thanks for everybody who's actually messaged me this week and asked, do I take clients on? I do. And we also have a membership so that you can begin to effectively take hold of your recovery and take one step at least every week for you. And you know where you're going as well. And you can use it with your own trauma recovery coach or with a therapist as well. Now today we want to talk about validation. And as I began to look into validation, I actually discovered that there's different layers of validation. And I went, wow, this is amazing, because when you hear or read stuff around the internet now about validation, it's actually people saying, open up, you know, bare your soul. And if you can't do that, then you can't be vulnerable with people. So thinking about vulnerability and validation at the same time as well, because it concerns me that if we're going to be vulnerable and we're looking for validation, then we also need to be aware that we can't just go looking for validation from every Tom, Dick or Harry running around the world, all right? And validation is vital for our recovery. And this is why we work with effective coaches and therapists, because in a safe relationship, we can be validated, not just for who we are, but for what's happened to us as well, because so much around the world, it happens. And unless people have been actively involved in what's happened in your life, they don't get it, all right? Too many people up to this point in time are still believing that if you change your mind, you change your thoughts, you change your, you know, get equipped to change your behavior, that you can do anything. But the challenge with complex trauma is that's never going to happen, because we've got things that have got to be healed internally as well. That's a whole other chat fest. So when I went looking at validation and found out there were different layers, I very quickly realized that we needed to look at our layers or levels of friendship and trust as well. So all of these infographics are available in all the libraries. Now, I just want to grab the friendship one for you, just so that you get a really good idea of what I'm talking about, okay? So we need to develop safe relationships, okay? We haven't had safe relationships. We often don't know what they are, and we often don't know that we've never had them. So I want you to be aware that this is normal, that we don't know that we've had them, and we also don't know how to consciously develop real relationships, like genuine relationships, because often we're codependent and it's all in. You know, if I'm in your life and I'm a friend, then I'm trusting you, we're just all in. But when I learned that there can be different layers of friendship as well, I went, oh my goodness, this makes sense how to take things slowly, all right? So from level one to level five, strangers, acquaintances, casual friends, close friends, intimate friends, that infographic's in the library. So I want you to think about this as we're going through. So these are definite layers that we can consciously develop to ensure that we're going to create healthy friendships, all right? And then when it comes to trust, these are the different layers for trust as well. So thinking about somebody coming into your life. So first of all, they're going to be an acquaintance. Then we may share external information about our life. Then we may share some ideas. And definitely if you're sharing ideas, it's a really good place where you can pick up narcissists, as in recognize them, not pick them up, recognize them. Then there's all these layers till we begin sharing internal information, All right. Now, validation is definitely going to come into when do we share internal information, okay? And then level five is sharing an intimate connection. And that means that it's somebody who we would trust with our life, all right? And that takes a long time to get there, once you know that it should take a long time to get there. So when you can see all these levels, it then makes sense why we should have lots of different levels for validation. Now, this infographic here, you might not be able to read it, but I want to assure you it's already sitting in the free complex PDS library and the professional library, which is part of the membership, okay? They're there. You can go and print them out, look at them. You can take them to your mental health professional and work with not only understanding each layer more, but what would this layer mean to you in your relationships, in your work? Where are you seeking validation? What do you need it to apply to in your life? And then the other side of this too is, where can I use this level to validate myself? Because we're not always going to have other people around to validate us and say, yes, this is definitely what's happening. Yes, it's crucial for complex trauma recovery, healthy complex trauma recovery, but we can also hold space for two things to happen, is that I can validate myself as well. So when we look at this, level one of validation is you're chatting to someone, you'll show interest, you'll be alert, you'll be listening actively, all right? So you're fully present in the exchange of communication between both of you, okay? You're there. But using the levels of trust, we're not really going to go deep into this, all right? Level two, we reflect the accuracy of the communication. So one word can make a big difference. So if somebody's saying to you, oh, look, I've been bullied and this and this and this and this happened, you would only have to say, I'm hearing that you've been bullied. And that one word says, I'm validating who you are and what's happening for you right now. So we can ask the person, I heard you say this, is that right? Or have I missed something? And this is at the early layers of friendship too, where we don't really know this person. All right. So I want you to think about that. We don't go into relationships automatically believing that we know this person. Even if we're really sensitive and we are aware of what's happening internally for them, we still don't rush ahead and talk in a way that says, oh, I know what's happening for this person. Right, we want to let that person reveal themselves. Level three is putting ourselves in their shoes. We want to read their emotions and thoughts and check for our accuracy. So we want to be able to do level two, which is speaking out about, have I heard this correct? And we also reach the stage where we can put ourselves in their shoes, all right? So we want to use empathy and compassion. Empathy we know lots about because we're so sensitive and it's beautiful and it's kind and we can understand more. But compassion is when I can hold space and I can separate what's happening for that person from me. I don't have to process everything at an emotional level. So at level three, we want to use empathy and compassion. Level four, we can validate based on a shared history. Are they speaking, or as they are speaking, think about their history and how what they are saying today reflects about your shared history. So think about the layers of friendship and trust. You've moved it further down. You've had time to get to know them more. You've had time to get to hear about their history. You've been able to be in spaces where you've put yourself in their shoes and you know that they do that too for you. And then we're going to validate them based on things that we've shared together, all right? So events that have happened in the same time frame that we've begun to know each other as people. Okay. And it's not about history from our past. Okay. This is simply about this level of validation. We've experienced some things together, and I can validate through that example. Okay. Level five is we want to validate based on our current combined circumstances. So, for example, we want to take into account how they're responding to us and how we may have impacted that response. So we get to the level of relationship where we're at that at least internal intimacy. So we have, again, shared experiences, but we also at the stage where we might have an argument and we want to be able to have a respectful, genuine conversation about how we may have impacted each other's emotions. Okay. So a simple one there is, I understand why you're upset as I forget to take the rubbish out repeatedly. Okay. It's acknowledging from that shared and combined physical experience in day-to-day life, really, as well. And level six is called radical genuineness. So the person can see our heart in our response to them. We don't try to change the conversation or need anything from the conversation. We are just there for them. So we've stopped reflecting on how we've played a part or how their past has played a part. I'm just radically here for you, in sitting in my heart center, and I'm just able to listen and say, yeah, I can understand how that's really, really challenging for you. We don't offer input. We don't need to, because they can really sense how genuine we are from our heart center. Okay. So if you want to print out these three infographics, they're all available in the libraries. And soon I'll have a book coming out about relationships so that you know the questions to ask in any of these situations as well. Okay. Remember to like, subscribe, and share for all of those suffering around the world who still don't have a voice. It's vital that we participate in each other's recovery to the best of our ability. And thank you for joining in and your comments. I love to hear from you, and feel welcome to ask questions at any point in time. Thank you.